Listen, it's scary starting out in HR leadership. It's one thing to be a part of a team, to be a specialist or even a generalist on the team. It's a completely different thing to have to lead that team and to be responsible for all the answers. You're a few years into your HR leadership role right now. You're seeing some glimmers of success, but nothing enough to make you feel super comfortable in your role. You've done a lot of great things and you've gotten a lot of early wins. You've gone back to school and gotten your master's degree. You've got your HR certifications, and you know that you've gotten multiple sheets of paper that tell you that you have what it takes to be successful in your HR role. So why is it that when you go back into your HR day, when you go into your office, when you hit Monday morning, you're still wondering, where do you start? What do you need to do? What do you need to think about? What are other HR leaders thinking about? And what does this mean for your HR career overall? Lately, you've had this nagging feeling that you can do more. You know that you've had some successes in your HR role, but there's more that you know that you can do. And then that, coupled with the pressure from your supervisor telling you that they want you to be more strategic, you're kind of at a loss. I understand exactly how you feel because I've been in your shoes, and I'm on a mission now to help you to grow your HR career. If we haven't met, I'm Brittany. I lead Thriving as an HR Department of One here on this channel, and I want to help you to grow your career. So subscribe to this channel, like this video, tune in for more videos just like this. Today, I want to talk about five things that I believe you need to know if you're working in HR leadership. These are things that you're not going to find in a textbook. These are things you're not going to necessarily know unless you experience them. And so pulling from my own experiences to help you along your journey, I'm honored to share this information with you. Working in HR can mean anything. You can be a benefit specialist. You can be a talent acquisition specialist. You can be an employee relations specialist. You can be an employee engagement specialist. There are so many things you can work on. But when you are leading in the HR department, you have to be kind of a master of all trades. And you want to make sure you have at least a working understanding of everything it takes to make a department successful. So today we're going to talk about what you need to know, what you need to focus on in your HR leadership role to make sure you are on the right path. First thing you want to know, never be afraid of hard work. Yes, HR can be challenging. And as with anything can be challenging if we're not putting the right kind of effort into it. And even with our best intentions, sometimes we can fall short if we don't keep our eyes on the right prize. So don't be afraid of hard work. Don't be afraid to roll up your sleeves and to really get in there and learn something new, especially when you're leading a department for the first time or you're leading a department on your own for the first time. It can be challenging to figure out where's your sweet spot. We all have our own favorite areas of HR. You might love the recruiting side. You might love the employee engagement side. You might have a specialty in benefits. But again, when you're working HR and you're leading the department, you have to do it all. And so you want to make sure that you are not afraid of hard work. You're not afraid of doing things that you might not like to do, and you're not afraid of challenges. By embracing these challenges and going about your day intentionally and making sure you are putting your best foot forward, putting your best effort forward, even in the face of adversity, it's going to help you to build that tenacity and build that level of endurance that you need to lead an HR department for the long haul. The main reason why I support HR Departments of One is because that was the season of my HR career over the last 15 years that I grew the most. As an HR Department of One, I felt like it was a sink or swim situation, and I had to do what it took to rise to the occasion. So I understand exactly how you feel, and that's why I created this channel to help support you on that journey. Yes, leading an HR department is hard. Yes, you might be solo in your role. No, you are not alone. Next thing you want to do when you're leading an HR department, you need to be your biggest cheerleader. Especially when you're leading a department as an HR Department of One, no one knows the ins and outs of every single thing that you do. There's really no way for anyone to really know all the work you put in, how you're thinking about it on your ride into work, how you're actually dreaming about this sometimes. There's no way for people to understand how difficult the role is and how much you put into the role. So for that reason, you must be your biggest cheerleader. I say it all the time, the thank you that you get from other people will never be big enough, and there's no reason why it can be. So you want to make sure you never wait on anyone else to congratulate you. You never wait on anyone else to give you that validation that you feel that you sometimes need. So to get around this, one thing that I found to help me be successful is to find ways to reward myself, set my own goals, set my own milestones to make sure I'm tracking my own progress, and reward myself when things go well. So rewarding myself can mean, you know, buying me the thing I've been eyeing on Amazon, or getting that special drink from Starbucks, or just making sure that I can sleep in on a Saturday and not feel guilty about it. But you know what's going to motivate you and make you feel successful, so you have to be intentional about doing that as well. Finding ways to pour into yourself is so, so important. That's why when I created my Thriving in HR Planner, it was one of the first sections I created. There's a section in the beginning of the planner about your personal and professional goals. And within that place, there's a challenge that you're going to have for a 12-month span of time where you can find different self-care activities to pour into yourself. I say it all the time as well. You pour into other people all the time on your jobs and your family life. So you want to make sure that you are intentionally pouring back into you. How can you be the best version of yourself if you're running on fumes? Next thing you want to know when leading your HR department is that you are exactly where you need to be right now. You're not behind the eight ball. You're not too far ahead. You're not far enough. You are exactly where you need to be. One of the great things that I've learned in life is that everything stacks on each other. And you're going to learn that as you grow in your HR career, especially if you're paying attention, the things that you learn your first month, your first year, your first 3 years are going to continue to stack on top of each other. From experiences that you have with your employees to experiences and engagement that you have with your leadership team. From being able to understand precedents that have been set by prior employees and from the things that you read and from the conference that you attend, everything stacks on top of each other. And especially when you're being intentional about what you're pouring into yourself and how you're learning and things of that nature. It's easy for any of us to develop that imposter syndrome feeling and feeling like you're not quite enough. I did an entire video about this topic, but you want to make sure that we get out of that mindset. If you are feeling like an imposter, think about it. That means that you really want to do the right thing. And would an imposter care about doing the right thing? No, not so much. And so you want to make sure that you understand you are in the exact right place that you need to be. You're doing all the right things. You're tuning into videos like this. You're pouring into yourself. You're learning even on your downtime. Hear my heart on this. You are doing everything that you need to do to make sure you are consistently growing and filling your own cup. Next thing I want to make sure that you do as you are leading your HR department is get into the habit of consistently learning new things. The only way you can really get stuck is when you stop learning. Think about it. If we have a plant in our home and our plant stops growing, what happens to that plant? That plant dies. If we have a child and one of our kids, if our kids stop growing, we're going to get concerned, right? If our kids are not hitting developmental milestones, if our kids aren't growing, if our kids aren't getting taller, getting bigger, getting faster, getting smarter, getting more able to do the things they're supposed to do, we will be concerned. So we need to be the same concern about our own selves. So again, when it comes to learning, never get complacent. I call it being comfortable. Never get comfortable and never rest on your own laurels. It doesn't matter how advanced your degrees are. It doesn't matter how many HR certifications that you have. If you're not consistently learning new things, you're going to get left behind. One of the reasons that you know that it's important for HR professionals specifically to continuously learn new things is that one, we have HR certifications. But more than that, number two, we have HR certifications that require us to get recertified. And we can get recertified in a variety of different ways, from taking specialty credential courses to recertification courses to just continuing to take the test over again and get recertified completely. But again, if HR professionals were not meant to continuously learn, there would be no need for the recertification. But because we continue to work in an environment and a world where people and strategies and departments continue to shift and evolve, so does the work that we do. So we have to continuously build our own toolkits, build our own resources, and build our own experiences to fit the workplaces around us. My biggest piece of advice for HR leaders as you are growing your career and building your departments is to work as if you are being recorded. That's my biggest piece of advice because integrity is everything. And when you're building your credibility as an HR professional, if you are not trustworthy, if you are not respected because of your trustworthiness, you are going to have a very, very difficult time. Just like, you know, we have friends that we wouldn't tell our deepest, darkest secrets to. We wouldn't even tell the time to because they're going to run and tell somebody else. We don't want to be those people. We want to make sure that we are trustworthy, we are credible, we are reliable, because employers are going to come to us in their darkest moments. Employers are going to come to us in their challenging moments. Leaders are going to count on us when things are out of their control and they want another set of opinions or they want another set of eyes on a certain situation. So again, anything that we do, we want to make sure we're working in integrity, we're working with trustworthiness. I think the best way to do that is to navigate every conversation, navigate every interaction as if you are being recorded. If you have this kind of mentality, it doesn't matter what anyone says that you did, it doesn't matter what you actually do, because you know that you wouldn't have done it if you didn't want anyone else to know about it. Anything that you do, be prepared for other people to know about it, whether it's a conversation, whether it's your tone of voice, whether it's your level of engagement within a meeting. Whatever you do, expect for people to know about it. Maybe no one will ever know about it, but what if they do? We're living in a day and age where everything lives on social media. So even things getting lost in translation or being taken out of context can end up going viral on the internet. So again, you're not going to be perfect and you don't want to not be yourself, but make sure you are bringing your best self into every interaction that you have with employees, with vendors, with leaders, and with other HR professionals as well. Your reputation really does precede you, so you want to make sure you are carefully crafting your own impression on other people. As an HR leader, there will be some mistakes that you make. Some things you're going to be able to learn by experience. Some things hopefully you can learn through this channel by helping you to navigate different things in a successful way. I believe by the grace of God, you found this video to help you to grow your career because it's exactly what you need in this moment. I'm on a mission to help you to bloom where you are planted in your HR career. So from these free videos to my paid programs and my paid resources, I want to help support you wherever you are. Whatever level of service you need at this time in your career, I'm here to help. Once you plug into this corner of the internet, you're going to find different resources to help you to grow your career, work more strategically, and have more impact. But your mindset is a big, big piece of all that. I've got an entire playlist full of videos to help you to grow your right mindset. So check out those videos and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.